Hello, everybody. They call me Muse, and welcome back to Hitman Freelancer, where we've got a new challenge to take on. We find ourselves in 47's wardrobe because we are doing a suit-only challenge this time. That's basically the beginning and the end of the rules, suit only. But we're going to be wearing different suits for every mission, I think. So we will bid farewell to the black streak for now. And let's pick out some new threads, and then we'll head to China. So here we are. I figured it might be raining, so I thought I'd bring the hoodie today. And now it's time to go about our business, I guess. Oh, what's that you say? Why have I got LVL 100 on the back of my hoodie? Well, as it happens, I've reached level 100 in Freelancer Mastery. Very kind of you to notice. And now that we've done that, it wasn't actually that hard, you know. It's like, people had been complaining a lot on Reddit about how difficult it was to get to from 90 to 100, how you needed loads of XP to get it done. But it just sort of happened for me whilst I was just enjoying myself playing Freelancer. So, yeah, there we go. I don't like the level 100 on the back of the hoodie, so I can't see myself wearing this in the future. But here's a bright idea for you. IOI. This one's
nothing for you, man.
free for you.
Probably sterilizing all the surfaces and
Increase
stuff.
the mastery level to 101, and then take the level 100 off the back of the jacket and replace it with an IOI logo that looks like a 101. But now I suppose we should probably look around and see where our targets might be. So we've got one in the inner courtyard there, and then we've got one in the facility. So yeah, this map, it's always going to be a mixed bag for suit only. It's like, if your targets are above ground on the streets or whatever, not a problem. But there is a lot of this level where you can't get to in a suit. So it's going to be quite the challenge. Well, not quite the challenge. We've still got silenced pistols available to us. But nonetheless, we're going to try and complete all the other challenges. It's just more fun if you complete the other challenges. So, who do we want to dart gun? If we dart gun this guy, is he just going to go into the facility and start vomiting everywhere? Maybe. Oh, he's an extra guy, is he? There's not normally three people stood there. So he's going to roam back and forth, perhaps. We will go around the other way then, take out the security guard, and then see what we can do about taking out that lad. I'm recording this post-awesome August patch. The August patch basically added nothing of merit. Maybe we'll poison this guy just because we can. They reverted a couple of things. And there we go, we've blown our disguise. That's a shame. But yeah. There are a couple of things that they added in the May patch that they just reverted in the August patch, such as removing the ability to press Alt F4,
What are you
and
trying to hide from, mister?
also removing the perfect run prestige because they just couldn't make it work properly. Right, so that guy's just roaming back and forth. Maybe he's not a bad bet for a Tanto kill.
Hey, come out and we'll talk. No need for any crazy stuff.
I'm not going to do crazy stuff. Wouldn't dream of it. But yeah, this is probably going to get violent and messy at various points.
Can't see him. I can't see him. Can anyone see him? I can't see him either.
Right, here they come again.
Wait, them all you there got.
Whoa. Received and understood.
Go.
Why can't I throw? I can't lock onto him around here. That's a real shame. So instead, we'll just run up here.
Oh, shoot!
Yeah, shoot. You run away, chef. Now, we want to take out the guard with a gun, probably. And we want to take out this lad with the Tanto. There we go. And now we need the gun back out because the guard is still alive. There we go. And we're dead. What got us? Oh, one of the other guards there. Never mind. So we've lost ourselves a few tools already, and a gun and a sword, because I was too busy trying to explain things and blundering around like a knob. Might have lost like 20,000 mercers as well. Yeah, we did. Oh well. On we go. We've not failed the challenges as a whole. Although we've lost our freelancer vision of the Seeker, which is unfortunate. But is it going to be back in here? Yeah. What else do we lose? Lockpick, screwdriver and wrench. That's fine. So, that leaves us with Wick Creek and Haven. Poison guard with a syringe, hide target bodies, don't play disguise. Hide target bodies, no bodies found, and poison kill. Eesh. Yeah, why not? And then headshot kill with a legendary. That would have to be a sniper rifle or an unsilenced shotgun. Sniper rifle makes it more likely. Let's see. We haven't got any epic assault rifles, have we? So yeah, here's the state the wall's in. I'm on Prestige 3 now. So as you can see, we're missing a whole bunch of stuff. But we're doing all right for legendary sniper rifles. We'll bring the Leviathan on. We've got a couple of epic pistols left. The stealth is awful, so let's bring that along just for the lols. And lockpick wise, do we want to, let's see, we need a poison kill, but we also want high target bodies, no bodies found, so I think that means lethal syringe is our best bet, because we can't just poison food, because then they'll just keel over in front of everyone, and that'd be sad. So we're going to poison one and we're going to snipe the other. And we're going to hide the bodies. Now, do we bring our collector's lockpick, or do we bring our freelancer crowbat? I think we'll go crowbat. And yeah, I suppose we should put on some proper clothes as well. Much as we could wear this suit, let's get dressed up before we head off to Wick Creek. And so here we are in our bloodied and battered suit with a tie that is kind of clipping through our body, I guess. Kind of hard to see. Yeah, doesn't look good anyway. But that's the sort of suit you wear when you've just been shot to death. Now, I see someone stands. Oh, of course they're both in James's house. Why wouldn't they be? So yeah, one of them's downstairs, which isn't an issue. The other one is upstairs, which is more of an issue.
Get along with the elderly. Stay away from a career where you make personal house calls for them.
So let us do the usual sort of thing you'd do in this situation. And jump over the fence into next door's garden. And then head down into the basement and see what we can see. These doors are no match for a professional crowbar person. And there's usually just the one guard down here. It's a hostile area, because of course it is. So I think we'll go for the poison kill, because syringing a guy upstairs is going to be harder than shooting him. But then we're going to need to get to him if we want to put him in a cupboard. So it's going to be tricky either way. So that's one guy down. Now that he's finished being dramatic and falling over, we will cupboard him. Yeah, no bodies found is going to be exceedingly tricky. Because getting around James's house without getting spotted or leaving a trail of bods doesn't seem that plausible. At least the cameras are off. So that guy Is he the one that goes out for... Ah, he might be the one who goes out for smokes every now and again. Or to check his phone or something along those lines. Yeah, who are you? You're going to be a fly in the ointment, aren't you? So let's get you out of the way if we can. Right, so you're just going to stand there, which is very kind. Now, in you come. And we can't tuck you in the cupboard because we're going to be using that to hide the body of our friend. So let's just drag you down this corridor, because even if someone does come down here, nobody goes down this corridor. I feel like I'm instinctively going to put on a disguise at some point that I shouldn't. But if I do that, I'll just change back out of it. It's no biggie. Now, is that our man? It is. There we go. I think we got his attention. Now, where did I leave my briefcase? Over here. Now, please come in.
Hello?
Hello. We're just gonna whip out the old sniper rifle if you don't mind. Blam you in the head with it. And then we're gonna pop you in a cupboard. And that is basically the sort of thing we're going to be trying to do. We're going to be trying to avoid what we did in China, where we just got shot to death within about a minute of starting. And what we're actually going to try to do is perfect super duper runs like this one. Now, whereabouts is our vendor? They're in the Schmidt property. So we'll pop around and see them as well, whilst we're around and about. You could potentially pick up a new gun from them. But then if it's a large one and we're carrying two large guns around, that could be risky for the escape. But we will see. We'll see how it goes. Now, what have you got? You've got an ornamental shotgun. That's pretty cool. We could get a Tanto back. However, the reason I took the Tanto for a katana kill on China is because it's pretty easy to get hold of again. So, sabers as well. I'm sure there's a level where you can pick up a saber. Do we take the lockpick or do we save the 3,000 mercers? Because we could get the lockpick back pretty quickly because we're only missing like three things from the freelancer crate, or four things maybe. So, heck with it, it might come in handy at any given moment. So we're going to be getting out of here with a big gun on our back. If anyone sees us, they're going to say, oi. But maybe that's fine. We're not terribly far from a level exit. So let's grab ourselves this paddle and let's make a run for it. As you can see, the exit is not terribly far away. This one only shows up when you've got the paddle in hand, though, so yeah. We're going to hop on our raft and sail away. And that will bring us to our first showdown. Now, for the showdowns, I've been more focusing on the actual challenges that I've got left to do than anything else. So, let's see. Let's grab our wrench back, because that's always handy. Yeah, it's a good selection of tools. And we're off to Haven. Poison a guard with a syringe. Right, we've got a dehydrated target. That is something that I was looking for. We'll take Silent Assassin, because I'm going to go for a poison kill. Because we need those. But I'm not going to bring any poison along, per se. No. Let's bring an emetic syringe for the guards. Maybe as a backup plan, I'll bring some lethal poison. But I'm not intending on using it because I want to work on two challenges at once here. All will be revealed though when we put on a suit and head to Haven. And here we are, Haven at night. How are we looking today? Looking pretty suave, all told. We've got a lookout though, right next to us, so we'll do our best to avoid them. Now, we've got a grey-haired person going up there. Are you our potential target? Necklace, grey hair, glasses, earrings. Potentially. Although, it's night time, so it's kind of hard to tell if you've got any tats. Looks like you've clearly got earrings. Oh. Now, yeah, you've got a necklace. You fit the bill, madam. We just need to see if you're going to drink anything. Now, she's headed over there. Is that to have a sup of anything? There's lookouts all around the gaff. And there we go, she's having a drink. So, I'm just going to go ahead and assume that she's our target at this stage. So the plan now is to poison her. I would also like, though, to turn off the cameras, just because it's generally a good idea. And so to do that, I'm going to head over to... Thank you. I'm going to head over to Tyson's villa. Now, by poisoning her, we are going to lose high target bodies. But I'm okay with that because we'll be getting Silent Assassin, which is worth a lot more dosh. Let's just try not to blow Silent Assassin picking up the poison, which I'm looking for to get this job done. Ah, oh, where's our wrench? Oh, there's our crowbar. That'll do the job. See that guard up there? He sometimes hears that. Is he going to hear it this time? Nope. Decided he's being deaf today. Still got a lockpick on us there, that's good. Maybe now he'll hear us. There we go. Don't even need this guard really, because normally I'd knock him out to get his disguise. But we don't need his disguise, we don't need the villa key. I was just doing this out of force of habit. But yeah, it's a very easy way to get a powerful disguise on Haven when you are playing
anyone there?
Regular and not suit only. Grab this Bartoli as well, just cuz. And then we will drag him this way into the bush, because I've tried just dragging him the other way into the bush and he did get spotted by a suspect at one point. Now, what have you got for us? Crate? Earphones. So we could go with the backup plan of strangle suspects wearing a necklace, because that's another challenge which I'm still yet to complete. I should have syringed that guy. I knew I was forgetting to do something. Ah, well. Let us sneak our way in. Where is that security recorder? There it is. And now we can go about our nefarious business. So, next step is getting the poison that I want. And to get that poison, there's at least one spot I know of where it could be got. There
nice
may be others.
Sir, really. But I'm sorry, I can't let you through.
Now, can we do this without getting spotted by anyone? That guy's going back that way, which is perfect. Come here, Froggy. Lovely stuff. So yeah, there's a challenge for poisoning people with natural poisons, like flowers or frogs. And then there's a second challenge for just poisoning people. So if we can poison this woman, then I think this will be the final one I need for natural selection. There's another suspect. Let's just double check. They've got grey hair. They're reading a book. That is one of our tells, and they're not wearing a hat. And they don't appear to be wearing glasses. Oh yeah, they are wearing glasses. So they kind of fit the bill. I can't really tell. Looks like they've got a necklace. Yeah, they've got a necklace. Do they have earrings on this side? Kind of hard to tell. So this guy is also potentially our target. This doesn't really complicate things. I'm going to assume if I see this guy drinking that he is in fact the one and not our gym lady. He's heading back towards the bar region. So potentially that's somewhere where he could have a sup. Nope, he's changed his mind. He's going that way. Heading towards Tyson's. Be nice to be able to just get up close and personal, but kind of blew that with the whole China debacle. And it's definitely not them because they're wearing a hat and they're eating. Nice to rule people out whilst we've got the chance.
Fine day, sir.
Right. Oops, nearly walked into a lookout. Because they're kind of hard to spot when they're on different floors. So, you again. Are you going to do anything other than drink? Would you care to perhaps partake in a cigarette or something of that nature? Anything that tells me whether or not you are in fact the one we want. I really hope you're not, because it's going to be a pain in the bag to get in here and get past all these lookouts and get that drink poisoned. Is that our other target? That looked like Ponytail Man. Yeah, that's Ponytail. And another lookout. Is he heading to one of these villas over here for a drink? Because I've seen people do that before. But I've also seen them eat over here. But no, he's just going to stand there and not do any tells. Very well. What are the odds of us getting away with syringing this assassin? Kind of slim, I guess. If it goes wrong, then we blow Silent Assassin, we blow Do Not Play Disguise, and we get shot to death. So maybe we don't risk that. Now, which hut are you headed to now? The shark hut, isn't that our hut?
Welcome,
I think
sir.
It is. And he's having a drink. He's actually having a drink. So this is our man. Yeah, he's just waltzed into our hut, I believe. And he's having a drink. And now he's just sat reading a book in our hut. How rude. Maybe we'll wait for him to go away again. And then we can give him a bit of poison. Because it seems like the targets only ever use the same one food or drink item at any given moment. So, yeah, let's lockpick our way into our own thing. That maid is busy over there, so we're going to poison this glass of whiskey by just cramming a frog into it. Just squidging it down in there. Lovely, frog on the rocks. And now that that's done, we just need to wait. So now would be a good time to try and find a guard that we can syringe without anyone else noticing. Could be tricky. Sightlines can be a pain on this map. We should probably do it away from the gym area, just because that's crawling with lookouts. I haven't seen that many lookouts around here. I really wish I'd syringed that villa guard earlier on, because that would have just been ideal. Maybe I can lure out a second villa guard. I suspect none of them are going to want to hear anything, but I do over here now. They're all a bit far away. You could lure guards out with gunshots and whatnot, but... it's a bit high risk. I mean, it's too bloody dark around here. Even with the extra lights that were added, this variation of Haven is just too damn dark. I'm going to have to turn it off, I think. Maybe we can get away with it here.
What? Hey, check that out.
Yeah, you go check that out, friend. Definitely wasn't me that did that. Lovely. So that's the challenge complete, and now we just need to wait for our target. Don't see anything suspicious, except your lunch. So yeah, here comes target friend again, I think. They do only have one spot where they can drink. And it looks like he's headed in that general direction. So while he does that, maybe we'll see if we can sneak past this army of lookouts that's over here and get to the supplier. I've come to the conclusion, by and large, that Silent Assassin is just not worth it on Freelancer. It's just so easy to break it. But I made an exception this time, because it was the only way we were getting a prestige challenge done.
If you got the cash, I got the product.
Maybe.
I'm listening.
What you got, madam? Jambeer. Can we pick that up in a level anywhere? Let's grab what we can.
I'll be around if you need more.
Nice briefcase full of gun. Could have got the knife, which was slightly cheaper, but we don't need to conceal what we're carrying at the moment. Because we haven't got another briefcase weapon, so
hello, sir.
Pick them up where you can, I guess. We kind of got back nearly everything that we lost in China. We're just lacking the epic pistol that we took with us, but that's fine. Now I guess we can sit around here and watch a water skier do his thing. Yep, he's coming back.
Good day.
You feeling better, friend? Yeah. Alright, I think our suspects just had another successful meeting. He's celebrating right now by flicking through the latest copy of Throb. And then once he's done with that, he'll probably want a nice whiskey that's definitely not full of mashed up frog guts. Or maybe he's off to another meeting. I'm not sure. He's just strolling around inside the security outpost right now. Which isn't helping anyone. Unless he's off to the gym to have a meeting with his fellow grey hair. Right, so he's gone upstairs in the security outpost. He's definitely waiting for a meeting at this point. Never mind. Scratch that. Scratch everything I just said. He's just gone up there to look around. And now he's realised that that's very silly and it's not helping any of us get anything done. So he's off for a stroll once again. This is kind of the downside of poisoning targets, is if they've got a big long loop, or they keep getting called away from their drinking spot to go to meetings and whatnot, it can take a little while to get things done. But we'll get there. You can only resist the lure of the frog for so long. So you've got a few maps you can do this natural selection challenge on. You got poisonous frogs here, you got poisonous flowers in Santa Fortuna, you got poisonous frogs in Wick Creek, so we could have done it there. And on reflection, that might have been a better bet just because it doesn't have as far to walk. But then a lot of the drinking and eating spots there are heavily guarded as well. and we would have blown high target bodies and no bodies found very quickly. Which this way we're netting a cool 8,500. Assuming, of course, I have got the right man. Which we should find out very soon. Yeah, it's beverage time. Oh dear. There we go, natural selection complete. My man has poisoned himself to death. And we've only got 7 more poisons to get the Don't Lick Me challenge. So, yeah, all is well. We're about to blow high target bodies. Because the assassin has gone in, I think. He's about to go in. Maybe if we'd got rid of the assassin, we would have been able to drag him into a cupboard or similar and get the whole gamut done. But it's a bit late now. Let's just take the boat home. There we go. Natural selection complete. And we're running out of challenges, really, that need doing. There's a handful left. Most of them involve killing leaders or just killing an absolute ton of people. But we'll get them all done. Let's see what fantastic loot that's earned us, shall we? A pistol. Grand. And is there anything left that we need from the crate? Just an emetic syringe. So nice to be able to use my freelance tools again after the last few challenges where I've not been able to. And we've probably got time for one more mission today, so let's take a look at where we might be headed. Now, New York loses some value. We've still got a lot of stuff we need to buy, but yeah, New York suit only. We're not going to be robbing that many vaults successfully, I feel. So, let's see where we might want to go. Oh, Colorado's just off the menu. That's just an accident waiting to happen, for sure. Do we try and remedy our mistakes on Chongqing as part of the espionage syndicate? I mean, suit only is part of one of the challenges, perhaps. So yeah, let's see. Oh, and it's alerted Chongqing, of course it is. Well, we'll save that for next week anyway. Today we'll do... I probably want to save Miami. Miami's got a lot of places you can go in just to suit. But Paris has too, because you can go upstairs in Paris without a problem, especially if you get the invitation to the auction. I think we'll save Miami. And today we'll finish off with Bangkok, I feel. Don't blow your disguise. Okay, doors stay locked. Ew. Only use one disguise. Right, we'll give it a try. And do we try and open the safe with an explosive? We don't know where it's going to be. It could be like on the third floor somewhere. So maybe we go for a melee kill epic. We've got an Eiffel Tower knife or something like that, haven't we? We do. Grand. Finish up today in a nice stylish suit, I think. The premier white suit. It's definitely hot here in Bangkok, so white seems the best bet. Now, where would our targets be? They're on lower levels. This is promising. Bob and Roy are our targets. Both on the ground floor. So, down we go. We're climbing through the window here, perhaps. We are most definitely allowed around and about. Roy is just a chap. He walks underneath this light fitting, which means he might be an accident kill down the line. But then we'd want Bob to be our melee kill guy. There's Bob. He's following the manager around. Always tricky. Coconuts are going to be no help. So, how do we deal with Bob? Without the manager causing trouble. Can we talk to her? What can we say to her?
Welcome, sir, to the Himapan Hotel. Do enjoy your stay.
Thank you. It's very kind of you, madam. Welcome to the Himalayas. Yeah, Bob is tricky. Although I know one place where he does definitely go, which wouldn't be the hardest place in the world to sneak into, perhaps. Depends if that woman is going to turn around or not. Doesn't look like she is. Good. Right, so they definitely come into this room together. But so does the other resort staff and the insecticide guy, the fumigator. Potentially we could snipe Bob in the head from here. Through one of these windows. No, I'm not 100% on that. Let's hide in here for a minute because it looks as though we're about to be interrupted. Right, she's still up there, just chatting away. Come on, madam. I can't wait for Bob all day, you know. I'm wondering if it is worth just trying to pop him in the head and dealing with the other guy. Because the other guy, we can probably seek her from somewhere quiet. Okay, someone notes a bullet impact. They're going to tell the guards, and the guards are going to come in and have a search around. So, once again, we lie low. Ah, here we go. She's finally on the move. So she's going to come back across here. Perhaps. Or is she going back to the bar? Ah, she's going outside, and then she's going to work her way around the back outside, and then through this room on her way back. Oh god, it's these two again. And I didn't notice them in time to get into my cupboard. Very well. That's fine, though. They'll be gone again, hopefully, before Bob and the manager get back in. Just about. Just about on their way in time. Maybe she doesn't come in here unless you make her by giving her the old seeker. But it's not her we're after anyway, it's Bob. There we go. Now he is going to come in this way for sure. He's going to start to head down the stairs. It's far enough, Bob. Now we just need to get out of this area without blowing our disguise, which we should be able to do by just walking past these guards, right? Lovely. Right, so that leaves one goal, really. Kilroy. And if we head up these stairs, we might stand a chance of doing that, because...
Who's the jittery guy?
I don't know, there's waiters and whatnot over here. I thought that would be a good spot to shoot down the lights on his head, but I guess not. But he might be on a long loop anyway, because he's gone for a stroll somewhere. There he is. He's coming back this way. So can we find a quiet spot for a seeker? Maybe not if Ken Morgan's also on the prowl. Do we want to prepare a toilet cubicle for him? Coming in. Oh, this could be ideal. Hi, Roy.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing much, just your impending demise.
No, no, no.
I guess we'll stick you in a cupboard, because where's the harm, eh? Still pretty sure that Bob hasn't been found yet, so technically this is another silent assassin. Once we get out of here. And we can do that by taking a nice stroll across the beach, I think. Lovely. Nothing incongruous about a white-suited man strolling across the beach like that. So there we go. A nice perfect silent assassin suit only run to finish off this first vid. As you can see, this challenge is not going to be without its pitfalls, but all being well, we can get it done soon enough. So join me next time for more suits, more suit only, and more fun. Thanks for watching, friends.